So now we're going to see about two important viral diseases, which is a major threat these days, okay? And I think the second one is taking the lead now. And yeah, let's see in detail about those diseases. One is AIDS. I'm not going to talk much about AIDS, as you guys are familiar, okay? But still, I would like to give a rough idea of what AIDS is, okay? So you know what AIDS stands for? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So syndrome is collection of symptoms, okay? Syndrome will not infect one system, it affects the multiple systems. That's why it's called a syndrome, okay? Now, AIDS will mainly infect your immune system, okay? So when immune system is affected, you're prone to all type of infections. So that is how, that is why AIDS is very, very, very deadly, okay? Now, December 1st is celebrated as World AIDS Day, okay? So now, AIDS is caused by a virus called as HIV, that is human immunodeficiency virus, okay? HIV is human immunodeficiency virus. So this AIDS, okay, so what happens in this AIDS is that main thing is an immune system is lowered, HIV, which will lower the immune system. It will bring down all the resistance in your body. So when you lose resistance, you'll get the disease. So AIDS can undergo, the virus can undergo this lysogenic cycle also. For example, he might be infected some few years and years ago, but still you might get the onset of the disease after some years because the virus would have undergone the lysogenic cycle. Okay, so now AIDS can be detected by ELISA test, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Okay, typhoid is detected by IDEL test and AIDS is detected by ELISA, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Okay, now in AIDS, okay, how will the infection spread? It is not through the touch or contact or anything. The infection spreads only through the body fluids. Okay, body fluids in the sense, blood, semen, everything. Okay, so how should you prevent AIDS is that proper sexual contact should be there. You should be very careful while doing this blood transfusion. Okay, so needles, it will go and touch one's body fluid. And if the same needles are reused, there is a chance of spreading. Blood while donating blood, you have to be very careful, okay? And then proper sexual life is one thing. So these are all the parameters which should be considered to prevent AIDS, okay? And how will you treat the patient with AIDS? So say there's no proper treatment these days, but still the best way is that you have to boost your immune system. The virus will keep destroying your immune system, so you have to eat well and boost up your immune system, okay? So AIDS is actually, how will it spread is mainly because of the sexual contact. Having sex with more than one partner will, you know, aggravate the frequency of the disease, okay? So considering all the points, if one is safe, if one is leading a hygienic life, when you go to the sanitary bathrooms and all, you have to make sure that things are clean, okay? If not, the chances of spreading is more. So all these should be considered so that we can prevent AIDS from spreading, okay? Next important disease which is ruling the world is nothing but cancer. I hope these days most of the people say they have this biopsy done and they are predicted with this. So what happens in cancer? Why is it so dreadful? Okay, so normally you have a mechanism called as contact inhibition. So what is this contact inhibition is that normally, okay, my cells, if I keep a cell in this tray, okay, it is a tray or a box, I keep one cell here, my cells will grow till what extent they'll grow is that until the container is full. Okay, if a cell is here, grow till here only. If it touches this, it will stop. So there is a mechanism called as contact inhibition. That is, the cells will stop multiplying when it touches each other. This cell will grow till here. This cell will grow till here. When these two touch, they'll stop growing. Okay, that's called contact inhibition. Okay, all our cells follow this contact inhibition. Okay, but the person affected by cancer, in him, this mechanism is lost. This contact inhibition mechanism is lost. So what happens is that the cells will grow like anything without any limit. And the growth will not be a, okay. So what's wrong if the cells are growing? You know, if you have 10 cells, I'm going to have million cells. So I'm going to be more powerful. So what is the problem there is that the cells are not growing properly. They're growing only fastly, but they're not growing properly. Okay. So what happens if these waste cells are growing faster, the nutrients and all the essential things which are required for the regular cells are deprived. Okay. See, 10 people in the room. Okay. If I dump you with 100, what happens? The 10 important ones, which is supposed to get the basic, essential things, they'll not get because of the other junk who came in, correct? So that is how it affects your body. Okay, so there's a protein called as P53. This will check your cell cycle, okay? A cell should be born, perform its function and die, okay? So that death of the cell is controlled by your P53 protein. This P53 mutation will also lead to cancer because in cancer, the cells will not die. The cells will become immortal, okay? So this P53 protein plays a... Now for treating cancer, this has been considered. This P53 is being targeted for treating the cancer, okay? So yes, that is all about your cancer. I mean, that is all about the mechanism. So let's see. Anything which causes cancer is a carcinogen. Okay. So anything which causes cancer is a carcinogen. So carcinogens can be of many types. It can be race, it can be a habit, it can be a lifestyle, it can be stress. Okay, there might be many factors which can act as a carcinogen. These all can cause mutation. Okay, carcinogens in specific are mainly your race. Okay, so any lifestyle, I would not say, okay, lifestyle in the sense, smoking, drinking, all these will end up in cancer, okay. And the gene responsible for cancer is nothing but your oncogene. So I told you by using PCR, okay, if a person A has got this oncogene, okay, so it may not be active now, but down the lane after 10 years, this might be activated and the person may get cancer, correct? By using PCR, I can amplify that sequence and I can find out 10 years before itself if the person will have the chance of getting cancer or not. Clear? So that is the importance of PCR. So oncogene is the cancer-causing gene. Okay. Now, based upon how is your cancer detected? Normally, they'll do a test called as biopsy test. Okay. So they'll just, cancer, if a person is having cancer, they'll have small lumps, okay. So they'll just scrape a layer from that lump and they'll do a histopathological study, okay. They'll check the growth of the cell by staining. If the growth rate is beyond what we expect, then that is for sure the cancerous tissue, okay. So biopsy and histopathological tests will be done for detecting this cancer, okay. So now, how will you treat the cancer? How will you treat the cancer? Cancer treatment is not, you cannot say only this, that. Okay, it's a combination therapy. So for example, the main thing which we do is radiation therapy. But in radiation therapy, what happens? When you're killing the cancerous cells, you're destroying some amount of your body's own cells also, correct? So that is why people will become weak after this radiation therapy and all. Next is chemotherapy, chemical treatment. Okay, they'll treat with the chemicals. Then immunotherapy. So by treating with your immunoglobulins, okay, immune cells. Next is your surgery. If it is not a spread, okay, surgery. Okay, surgery means they'll just surgically remove that part, okay. So when will they do surgery is that you have two types of cancer here, okay. One is spreading type. The other one is non-spreading type. Okay, so spreading type is actually called as, okay, in spreading type, metastasis is present. Metastasis is present in spreading type. So that means the cells will get along the bloodstream and cause the infection in all other parts of the body. So metastasis is seen. Here, there is no metastasis. Okay, so these are all the two types. So in this non-spreading type, I will surgically remove. Even in the spreading type, I will remove and then I'll treat it with this. But in non-spreading type, I'll just surgically remove and I don't have to use the other therapeutic application. And other treatment is now by using alpha interferons. You know interferons will fight against the viruses. So alpha interferon, now the recent one is your targeted drug therapy. That means you will target only your cancerous cell, and to those cells only the drugs will go, so that your normal cells are not destroyed. Okay, so that's called as targeted drug therapy. Okay, so metastasis, if it is present, it is dreadful one. Okay, if it is not present, then it is a normal one. Okay, okay. Now, based upon the origin of your cancerous cells, you have four types of division. One is sarcoma. Then melanoma, lymphoma. Okay, so sarcoma is from epidermal origin, melanoma is skin cancer, lymphoma or leukemia, it's also called as leukemia. Leukemia is your blood cancer. So based upon the origin, you have these many classifications. Okay, so with this we are done with human health.